peoples go for the next one. It is nothing but circle diagram. In induction motor, it is a very important diagram. I already told this issue something. By making a circuit diagram, we can easily predict all the parameters ranges, which means of capability levels of the particular parameters can be easily predicted. So to calculate this circle diagram, we need a basic test, which is nothing but a no load and block to rotor test. We already did that. By conducting a no load test, we got this information, V naught, I naught and W naught. By using W naught, you can calculate the phi naught value. Then by conducting block to rotor test, you got this information, VB, IB, WB. Then by using WB, you can find the IB value. Then you also need some other important data to construct the circle diagram. The three things are there. One is nothing but ISN, which is nothing but short circuit current under normal voltage. Then one more thing, WSN, short circuit power, input power under normal voltage. Then a third thing also there, it is nothing but power scale. It is used to measure all the parameters in the unit of watts. So let's construct the first one. You have to fix two scales, horizontal and vertical scales. Then fix vertical scales as a current scale. Then fix some current related to ISN value, then I naught value. Then after fixing, you have to draw a line. This line is constructed by I naught with the angle of phi naught from the vertical axis. So after that, this edge of this line should be marked as a reference line. So draw the line of reference. This is considered as a reference now. Then after this, draw one more line by using ISN with the angle of phi B. So this line is considered as a larger when compared to I naught line. So after draw this line, you have to joining that edge of this I naught line and ISN line, that line should be considered as output line. So the last line, what you see is nothing but output line. Now you're going to bisect the output line. So draw a line which is bisect the output line. That bisect line will intersect the reference line. That point is considered as C, center of the circle. So by make this point, you can draw the semicircle on this type. Actually, it is not a semicircle. While drawing, you got the neat semicircle. Now, after the semicircle, you got this point that the top portion of output line with that point, you have to draw one vertical line there. This vertical line should be considered as a losses. This is the total loss of the machine. Here, upper part is considered as a copper loss, lower part is considered as a fixed loss. In fixed loss, iron and mechanical losses are clubbed. So this is the thing. Now you need to declare about a copper loss is you have to segregate the copper losses. Now we had two portions here, which means of stator copper loss as well as rotor copper loss. It is separated by a torque line. So a separate equation for the torque line calculation for the slip ring as well as a squirrel cage. If the data are there, we can proceed on that scenario, or else we can make it as a 50-50 of portion. So make this 50-50 and draw a line. This line is called as torque line. So that's all for the basic data. Hereafter, you need to calculate a parameter for a condition. So here, for the full load condition, the first thing is you need to calculate the power scale, a length of that vertical line in the topmost of the output. With the length, you have to divide with that centimeter. By this way, you can gather the power scale value for the 1 centimeter, how much of power. After calculating the power scale, with the machine rating, you have to draw a straight line on the top of the circle. That length will relate to the capacity of the machine. Then with the scaling of power scale. Then after that, you have in particular that line, you have to draw a line with a parallel to the output line. So like this. So this line will intersect the circle on the two times. You have to consider about the lower intersect value. So on that point, you have to draw one straight line. That's all, people. that straight line is nothing but a mark value of calculating all the parameters under a full load condition. So you have to mention here the parameters PQRS. With this PQRS, with the proper value and the multiplication with the power scale, you can calibrate all the datas. This is the procedure to draw the circle diagram. Once you completed, you got this kind of complete circle diagram. So all the notifications are there. While making the video, I cannot able to make the notification. Now see this diagram to mark all the notifications here. That CD is nothing but rotor copper loss, DE is nothing but stator copper loss, EF is nothing but fixed losses. Then a line of PT is PQRST is there. That PT is considerably a full load parameters. Then all other things, that M and H is nothing but to finding the maximum values. That's all for that. I think so here no need to draw the circle diagram in a problematic areas, but in theoretical you need to know about the procedure. I think so everyone know about this thing. Just consider this as a recall. Then go for the next one. This is depreciation coefficient. Here this is the value of induction motor, which depends on the power factor. The power factor of the induction motor depend on two factors. The two factor is nothing but magnetizing current and short circuit current, ideal short circuit current. These two things are discussed on the previous sessions. The magnetizing current is nothing but IM, short circuit current is nothing but ISC. From these two things, we can decide the power factor value. So this coefficient will deals this work. A depreciation coefficient is nothing but it is noted as rho, and it is defined as the ratio of magnetizing current by ideal short circuit current. The equation is below there. So rho is equal to IM divided by ISC and I. For ideal purpose, it is denoted as I. These two equations is derived in the previous content. IM is magnetizing current per phase. IM is equal to 0.427 P 8060 divided by KWSTS. Then here the ideal short circuit current, I is equal to the same thing V by R, but here it is, instead of V it is E, instead of R it is X, the reactance content. Okay, with this two equation we can easily calculate the depreciation coefficient. It is regularly asking in a 2-mark session. Just concentrate on this thing. Then alternative formula is there for current, short circuit current. E is divided by XS. It is nothing but ISE. Equation of 0.55 BAV DKWS QS divided by TS divided by lambda. Here the lambda is nothing but a specific permeance. That permeance is calculated by summation of all the four factors, lambda S, lambda naught, lambda N and lambda Z. These all the things are constant. Then by this way we can calculate this ISC value. With this ISC value, the final depreciation coefficient value is defined as IM divided by ISC, and simplified equations are given there. With this data, that particular one more thing is there, LGS, which is nothing but effective gap length, that KS and LS value. Then the effect of depreciation coefficient on the induction motor is, it will have a maximum power factor. By making this value, we can make the power factor as maximum. Then this value will decreases the overload capacity of the machine. The third thing, when depreciation coefficient will increases, then it will also increases the air gap length. So because of this thing, while designing of induction motor, this depreciation coefficient is an important factor to consider on the area of air gap length, capacity and power factor. That's all.